I am Aston Farquharson from New Species Corporation, and you are watching Spiritual Injection.
Today I have with me Jermaine Edwards. Jermaine, it's great having you here.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure.
So tell us how you got started in Christianity.
Well, you know, as some persons started off in church, they just saw persons getting baptized. Because I mean, I was very young, extremely young. Like, I think probably not even in my teens as yet. So I saw a lot of persons getting baptized, and I wanted to get baptized because it looked very interesting. And I got baptized, and from that, you know, because your father knows Jesus, your mother knows Jesus, so you just why not?
Yeah.
But it was, you know, way up in my teens when I really understand who Jesus Christ really was. And based on my experiences with him, you know, and then it grew from there. So I wouldn't say I was 100% a Christian when I got baptized, but it's after realizing and accepting God for my own personal savior as a more adult. Then that's when I accepted Jesus Christ totally and I gave him my life.
Okay, great. So in terms of the music and the singing, how did that come about? How did that start?
Well, my father forced me to play the keyboard, and I thought it was very unfair because I wanted to play football when I was younger. But he said I should play the keyboard, which I thank him today for doing that because you know, that helped me. I didn't have no other, well, I wouldn't say I don't have any other skills in the sense of other stuff that I do. But I wasn't interested in academics. I was just more interested in music and so forth. So that started playing the keyboard at age 9. Then after I started playing the keyboard at age 9, singing came years after, which nobody thought I would have sung, but I was forced into the position of being a praise and worship leader. Because both of the praise and worship leaders left. So that was when people said, whoa. You know, and then I started singing this group, you know, Living Lights, and here I am today.
Wow, great. And we know you're one of the top gospel artists in the industry today. Congrats for that.
Thank you.
What are some of the challenges you face?
Well, as a gospel artist, I can't say top artist or whatever. But as a gospel artist, the stress of popularity, people using you, people, you know, borrowing a lot, people just always believing that you're all right, but you know, you're there to support and help others, but persons sometimes they think you're all right. So you know, just the stress of being lonely sometimes, you know, of can't finding somebody to take your stress away, and but you know, other than that, the stress of even being to trying to be normal, like being like everybody else, you know what I mean, when there's a calling upon your life, you have to be obedient to God. So that's the challenge that I face. And sometimes you can reach a very huge crossroad. And you have to just decide, God, I'm going to go with you.
Absolutely. Okay. We'll hear more from Jermaine Edwards after this.
Does he know about how I can't get to sleep at night? Does he know about all this pain and tears I cry? Does he know about the things I done, everything under the sun? Does he know all of our secrets we hold till time? Does he know how hard it is to hold sometimes? Does he know my weakness when I feel like I want to choke somebody? Does he know all of my needs beyond my thoughts? Does he know all of my joy that I lost? He knows.
Welcome back to Spiritual Injection. So we have Jermaine Edwards in studio with us. And before we went to break, we were talking about some of the challenges, Jermaine, in terms of, you know, ministering and your daily walk with God. Tell us a bit more about that.
All right. I got married at age 19.
Wow.
Right. So, and I've been married now for the past 13 years. A long time, but you know, even being married, you know, you grow up and you see other persons and so forth and so on, but you have to keep focus on what that relationship, you know, you have girls all over the place coming at you and so forth. You have to keep focus on knowing that, look, your choice is this, and God say He honors this, and this is what I want to do. And
absolutely,
you know, and for the fact that you know, have like labels that would come at you, you know, today that look, you must stop singing about Jesus and you know, the sing things that are lovely, you know, people are singing. I even have this song, like, at the end of the day, I want to make you smile. You know, one white guy was like, wow, you know what that could be if you're just a girl, at the end of the day, I want to make you smile. That would have been a youth song. But I said, you know what, at the end of the day, I want to make God smile. That's the most important thing. So you have stuff like that, you know, even in my own girl, my Christian life, when I reached this place where I'm, you know, it was the scriptures that helped me, the word of God, that God let me get this newer relationship with Him, understanding who He is, because growing up in church, I didn't really understand everything, you know what I mean? So I had to go and research for myself, and that is where the peace of God came upon me, and I got the answers through the word of God.
Okay, great. And do you know that we have this contest that's a part of the show? What would you say to young artists who are auditioning, who, you know, want to grow, who are into gospel, but as you say, come across these challenges? What would you say to them?
Well, one thing I can say, I am probably one of the few gospel artists in Jamaica who didn't do no promotion at all. No marketing in the sense of any posters. You won't see a Jermaine Edwards album in store. You won't see any of that because I didn't pay attention to that. Which I know I should have done that, but it was a passion and a soul that came through my music that people love. You connect them. The traveling that I do, the shows that I do, is because of the soul and what we do. So I'm encouraging anybody who's going to be singing and singing the word gospel music, sing from your heart, sing sing the truth, sing what you're going through, and people will connect with what you're going through.
Absolutely. Okay, great words from Jermaine Edwards. We'll be back right after this. Change your water, change your life. Maytal Miracle Alkaline Water is your way to a better health. How does it enhance your health? It counteracts excess acid, maintains pH balance, helps to prevent diseases and disorders. It maintains strong bones and teeth, slows down the aging process, maintains an optimal health and energy, and flushes out the toxins from cells. As well, provides essential minerals. Maytal Miracle Alkaline Water, changing your water will change your life.
New Species' newest product, Caveman. Powerful, you see? This is what I am now taking. And boy, I feel like a giant.
For more information, call New Species now, get a free consultation, and visit our website at nuspecies.com.
Van Wyck's Motor Clinic, your one-stop premier car care center. With professional and personalized services, we offer electrical repairs, computerized wheel alignment and balance, auto detailing, body reconditioning, mechanical repairs, engine scans, and much more. Van Wyck's Motor Clinic, your one-stop premier car care center.